All right, guys, here is lowdown for today's video. So I have done some lists of actors that nobody wants to work with, and you guys enjoyed it so much that I cannot just limit it to actors, because along with the actors, there are celebrities too, in general, that no one wants to work with. So today on Beyond the Screen, I am gonna be dishing out 10 celebrities that no one wants to work with. I'm your host for this one, I'm Joss Bedard. Come say hi to us on social media. You can find our links, they are down below, super easy. But for now, I say we get into today's list. Kicking off this countdown list is the one and only Beyonce. Maybe when you have a net worth like hers, you can demand certain things that people like me never could. Back in 2013, articles surfaced exposing different diva behavior and demands that she had on her world tour. An alleged tour writer came forward and leaked that she demanded ridiculous things throughout the process. Some of them were that her water must be chilled to 21 degrees and served with $900 titanium straws, the bathrooms must have new toilet seats and red toilet paper at every venue, and hand-carved ice balls had to be made for her to cool down her throat after every show. One of the arenas in the UK confirmed that she does need a lot of space backstage, and they had to provide her with these huge luxury dressing rooms for one person, which normally accommodates an entire sports team. Next up at number 9 is Johnny Depp. For a long time in his career, he was one of the most popular and respected actors in the industry. But over the past few years, he's been going through a lot of personal issues, most of which we have all seen over the media, which could be why he's had some conflict with people he has worked with. In 2018, he got sued after a crew member from City of Lies alleged that he had punched him. The man named Greg Brooks said he reeked of alcohol and got angry when he told the actor that they had one more attempt at the scene after many failed ones due to the actor being drunk or hungover. Apparently, he punched Greg in the ribs twice and even said that he would pay him $100,000 to punch him back. But Greg refused to engage in the fight and sued him instead. If you follow the actor, you know that he's going through a lot right now, but regardless, no one wants to show up to work to get punched in the ribs. Sliding into our number 8 spot is Bruce Willis. Similar to Johnny Depp, it appears like his reputation has changed over the years, and he is now considered to be one of the more difficult Hollywood actors to work with. He's been called out for bad behavior on set on more than one occasion, but the first time was in 2010 when he filmed Cop Out. The director, Kevin Smith, talked about his experience working with the actor and said it was soul-crushing. Apparently at the wrap party, he said, "I want to thank everyone who worked on the film, except Bruce Willis, who is an effing D word." And just a few years later, Sylvester Stallone dropped him from Expendables 3 and called him greedy and lazy, saying that he demanded a pay increase. So overall, just not a good reputation behind what we see on the screen. Moving along to number 7, we have Lacey Chabert. Most people will know her better as Gretchen Wiener from Mean Girls, which is part of the reason why no one really wants to work with her anymore. It's not that she's a diva or has a bad reputation, she's actually very nice. But she herself has admitted that despite the fact she's done other work, people always typecast her with Gretchen, which basically just shadows over all of her other films. She's actually done 16 Hallmark Channel productions, and most people don't even know. Not to mention, her films haven't ranked in a ton of money, so she isn't as appealing as other actors when it comes to casting. But that has not stopped her from continuing a career and shifting her priorities a bit, and by that, I mean that Gretchen Wiener is now a mom. Cruising to the number 6 spot is Mickey Rourke. Throughout the 80s, he was a hot commodity in the industry, but then things took a turn for the worse and he started gaining a nasty reputation for his outspoken and rude behavior. He landed on Hollywood's blacklist, so he turned to boxing instead for a number of years, but then made his return back to acting in 1997. He took on the villain in Marvel's Iron Man 2 movie, which is a huge opportunity for all actors, but his back talk soon became an issue again. Apparently, he badmouthed the entire production and even called the leading man of Marvel, Kevin Feige, a nerd. He's been the first to admit his wrongs though. He once explained that he doesn't deserve an Oscar. He said, "I stupidly said acting wasn't a job for a real man. I threatened producers, raged at directors, and forgot my agent's name. I really burned my bridges."
Well, at least you can admit it.
Halfway through number 5 is Kiefer Sutherland. Some people have been vocal about enjoying their time working with the actor, but others have expressed that he's been very difficult to work with. So everyone might have a different experience and opinion based on their work with him. A fellow actor, Freddie Prinze Jr., was one of the people who said he had a horrible experience working with him. He spoke on it and said, I quote, I did 24. It was terrible. I hated every moment of it. Kiefer was the most unprofessional dude in the world. That's not me talking trash, I would say to his face. Everybody that's worked with him has said it. He even went as far as saying that he is part of the reason why he wanted to quit the business and actually slow down on his acting. And he's not the only co-star to come forward with claims like these. But there's just too many examples for me to get through, so trust my word when I say, people online have spoken, and yeah, more than one co-star has said he's pretty hard to work with. Sniping the number 4 slot is Misha Barton. She made it big from her role as Marissa Cooper on the hit TV series The OC. She was even the youngest cast member at the time compared to the other leads. But one of her co-stars, Tate Donovan, spoke about the filming experience and said that she was, I quote, the biggest diva on set. She had some trouble getting roles after that, with other people claiming that she had this sense of entitlement. As time has gone on, we've seen her slowly disappear from the spotlight after having issues with the law and a substance abuse. In recent years, she's tried to make a return, but can't seem to land any roles. She did appear on MTV's reality show The Hills, the new reboot, but the reality show didn't get a second season. Alright guys, we made it to number 3 and we have Macaulay Culkin. It's not totally surprising that he's on this list, but we have to admit that it is a shame. He was a huge child star that the majority of people adored watching every Christmas in his series Home Alone. Throughout his career though, things got bad and he quit acting, totally disappearing from the spotlight for years. His addiction and struggle with substance abuse kept him out of Hollywood for a long time, but in recent years he has tried to make a comeback. It's hard for him to book roles now though, with his past and also his current erratic behavior. Not to mention he is closely tied to Michael Jackson and has always come to the legend's defense, despite the horrible claims other men have made about him sexually assaulting them. He's made some comments and jokes about the victim's recent documentary, and many people thought that it was very insensitive and disrespectful, and yeah, I can see why they might not want to work with him. Winning the number 2 spot is Isaiah Washington, another talented actor who started to get a bad rep back in 2006 when reports surfaced that he had used a gay slur on the set of Grey's Anatomy towards his co-star T.R. Knight. He received a ton of backlash and issued an apology. He was able to gain some forgiveness from people, but definitely not all. 1 year later, he stirred up another controversy at the 2007 Golden Globes when he was caught uttering another anti-gay slur while he was backstage. He then issued a second apology and admitted that ABC had asked him to go through a counseling program. However, they couldn't be so forgiving to the actor who just keeps repeating the same mistake, so ABC decided that they had to fire him from his full-time role on the hit TV series Grey's Anatomy. In our number 1 spot is Amber Heard. You've probably heard of the chaotic lawsuit going on between Amber and her ex-husband Johnny Depp. It's been an ongoing lawsuit after she made claims that he had abused her, but then audio footage surfaced where she admitted that she made it up and that she hits him. The audio revealed her saying that no one would believe him and she would be able to ruin his career, basically. Honestly, it's pretty hard to listen to. I listened to the whole thing. People everywhere have been infuriated, and fans even started a petition on change.org to have her removed from Aquaman 2. As of February 4th, 2020, over 110,000 people have signed the petition and said that she deserves to be punished and not glamorize a domestic abuser. In their words, that's what they've said. The couple is gonna settle it in court later this year, but in the meantime, she is facing a lot of negative attention, so it wouldn't be surprising to me if no one wanted to associate themselves with her just simply for that fact. Alright guys, there is 10 more celebrities that no one wants to work with. Let me know in the comments what you are thinking, and give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. If you can think of some celebrities no one wants to work with, let me know. I want to hear them. But for now, I'm going to respond to some of your comments. Bo Van Desh Bosch says, haha, your sweater says Oma without your sleeves. That's the Dutch word for grandma. Love your videos, by the way. That is not what I was going for. It did say woman, but I understand that it probably looks like grandma. Crimson underscore Carson says, Jocelyn is that one person who is the first in the buffet line. You are not wrong. I will be the first, I will be last, and I will be the person who eats off their plate while they're still in line. And I'm not even kidding. One American at Large says, why would anybody even want a picture of Amy Schumer in the first place? I would want a picture with Amy Schumer. I actually really like Amy Schumer. Yeah, Shingla says, that one YouTuber whose videos I'll watch even if I'm dead asleep. Love you, Jocelyn. I'm a little confused. How can you watch my videos if you're dead asleep? I can watch them even if I'm dead asleep. Bruh, does that mean I'm in your dreams? Is that what you're trying to say? Ooh, a little pickup line happening here. All right, guys, I'm getting out of here. That's all I have left. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. And if you want to keep hanging out with me every day, make sure you ring that notification bell so you never miss another video.